Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. We are on issue number 7. I'm going to be making nice Moroccan mint tea. It is a common drink in Morocco, just like how coffee is for Ethiopians and Eritreans. I'm going to be comparing the stub and the liquorice. Not necessarily which is better, it's whichever you prefer, but I definitely want to talk about my experience with both, what I like and dislike about each one, or you know, the pros and cons. The last video I talked about self-care this year, that's one of my goals. And then sometimes it doesn't have to be big, it can be the little things. We're going to be taking a nice walk, just chilling, enjoying the breeze, enjoying the weather, getting some vitamin D, taking a nice walk. And I hope you enjoy. Do not forget to subscribe. Do not forget to follow me on Instagram. Hope your new year is going well. If not, I pray that it gets better. But be patient with yourself, be obedient to God, and all will fall in place. Okay. All right, I know many of us have heard of Moroccan mint tea before, and I don't know about you, but I used to just think it was just mint tea. I didn't understand the big hype about Moroccan mint tea, but I've come to learn it's more than that. So I want to try it for myself. First, you need mint tea leaves. Then you need green tea. Mix those two together. Put in your tea bag. Put it in a cup. Add your hot water. Add your sugar, and boom, you got yourself a Moroccan mint tea. Now all you need is a cute Moroccan cups or Moroccan glasses to drink out of. But unfortunately, I don't have one, so I'm going to use this nice Anthropologie teacup. Enjoy. Those who know me know that I love me some cast iron pots and pans. And if you follow me on Instagram, I talk about this all the time. And I've said it many times, I definitely want to build my collection. I just recently received the Staub cast iron, La Coquette, I would say, during the Black Friday sale. And I got another one for Christmas, which I love. All right, and I had my Le Creuset one from last year Christmas. I got that for Christmas. So my husband's on the thing, and I said it and he listened. I'm so happy. I was like, I want one every year for Christmas, and he's following through. I got this last year, and I got the other black one this year for Christmas, which is not in this video, but I've showed it on my Instagram. Once again, follow me so you're in the know. Now to do a comparison, right? Pros and cons of both. So let's start with the Le Creuset. It's definitely lighter than the Staub. Don't get me wrong, cast iron is heavy, period. But this is lighter than the Staub. The Staub is way heavier, you know. It is easier to clean because it has the enamel in the inside. I know when you see the burnt marks, that's when I made popcorn and I put olive oil in the burnt. However, one thing I like about the Le Creuset is they do have a special soap they can use to wipe away or clean out burnt marks, which I want to get. It's on Amazon for like $22. I will definitely be ordering that. But prior to that burn for the popcorn, listen, when I burn meat or anything like that, it was like easy to clean. I put some water and soap, let it sit for about an hour or 30 minutes, wipe it clean, right? And it stays white, you know, with any type of burns. So that's another pros for the Le Creuset. They have beautiful, vibrant colors. There's this color called Caribbean. I want, there's like this nice mint green one. It's gorgeous. They have really, really vibrant colors. So imagine that in your kitchen. It's like, whoa. And they have beautiful yellow, orange, obviously. This one's called the Flame. You have teals. Like when I say they have an array of colors, they have an array of colors. So I love how vibrant their colors are, right? So I love that. Now for the cons for the Le Creuset. One of the cons is it's more expensive like than the Staub. It's like they're both expensive, but Le Creuset could run you another 100 or 200. It's more of a popular one, but you know, if you're on a budget, if you're going to splurge a certain amount of money, I would definitely say try the Staub. It's a little bit cheaper. But if you have the funds to do it, it will not hurt to also get yourself a Le Creuset. Another con is because it's white. This is really why I looked into the stuff. Because it's white, I make curry chicken. I use turmeric a lot in my cooking. And I was afraid to use turmeric in my cooking with this lake rosé. Love it for the look. It looked beautiful, but I'm afraid to cook certain meals in it because I'm afraid it's going to stain. So that's another con. Another con too is, and I didn't realize this until I got my stub and I did a comparison. This knob, because it's metal, it gets hot. It gets hot. So you need like a napkin or some type of glove to pick or open things, open up the pot. But it gets hot. And you will see, it don't get as bad as the stub, but it definitely gets hot. So if you don't know, now you know. Get a glove before you open this thing or you're going to burn yourself when you are cooking. So it gets like, that's the only thing that I don't like. It's beautiful. I see that sometimes they have a gold knob. It's gorgeous. Sometimes I'll be wishing they could rubberize it, but then it would take away the look. So it's like you sacrifice safety for look, you know. But yeah, that's the only thing. It gets hot, so careful. In terms of the stub, as I said, it's cheaper in price, so if you're on a budget, stub is the way to go. Another thing I love about stub, they have like Lakers, they have the vibrant colors. Stub have the rich colors. Look at this blue, like come through. They have a green one that's called basil, beautiful green color. Another one that's it's like a Gerardine type of color, beautiful red color. They have such beautiful colors. And another thing I love about the richness of the color, it is another pros is they're so glossy. As you can see, this one is glossier than this, right? So it's like, imagine this in your kitchen. That's really what draws me to the stuff, because the colors are gorgeous. It is glossy, like it looks so nice in the kitchen. So that's another pro. It is glossy, the colors are rich, okay? This got liquors, they got the vibrancy of the colors, and this one got the richness of colors, right? So I love this for the richness and the glossiness of the pot. And for some reason, maybe I'm just because of the colors, the sizes that I got, it seems that even though, not comparing these two, but sometimes the lake is there because of the shape, it seems smaller than the stub. Like this is not big of a size, but because of the shape, it could hold a lot. So it seems bigger, right? And you know, because the bigger the sizes, the more it costs. So if you're on the budget, once again, and you want something that could fit a lot or enough, the stub, because it seems like because of the shape that they shape mostly pots in, it seems bigger than the, the Le Creuset. And remember, the bigger it is, the heavier it is. So this is already heavy. You don't want anything bigger than this because it gets crazy. So yeah, that's another pro. Now for the cons about the stub. This thing gets so hot so quick. The first time I used it, I did not know. And it makes sense because it's attached to this. So it gets hot. And this thing collects the water or the steam, and the water and the steam goes back into your food. And that helps it cook quicker. So I do love that about that. And the Lake Rosé doesn't have that, as you can see. So that's another thing. But because of this, this baby gets so hot. I burned the crap out of myself the first time I used it. I'm like, oh, snappy snap. And it made me compare, like, I remember ever getting burned by the knob from the Le Creuset. And then I cooked in the Le Creuset and I realized it gets hot too, but not as bad as this. I don't know if because of the finishing. I don't know, because they're both metal, but this one is glossier than this, but it gets really hot. That's another con that I do not like. It's very heavy. It is very, very, very heavy. It's way heavier than this. I forgot how many pounds this one is, but it's heavy. It's heavy. So if you know you got chicken hands and chicken wrists, then your wrist can't handle. They're both heavy, but this is lighter. This gets really, this is like iron. Okay, it gets heavy. So that's another con about the stub. But this one, it seems to burn quicker than the Le Creuset. I don't know if it's because of the enamel, and they're both enamel finish, but it seems like this, it takes a little while for it to burn. It burns if, like, obviously my fire is on high, but still take a little bit quicker to burn. But this one seems like burns quicker, and that's one con. And another con too is like, it seems like it's harder to clean. both the outside and the inside. Like, you have to really, really scrub it out. Like, I burned the new one I got. I was making lamb and I was doing schoolwork, totally forgot about to burn it. I had to scrub for a little bit. And I know that even with this, I could have just put water, some soap, let it sit for a little bit, and it would have just came off. So, I guess because it's still a little bit more, in terms of, it's not as, it don't seem like it's as enameled as the Le Creuset. So, I guess it's a little bit more raw and it holds stuff in more than the Le Creuset does. So, that's another con about the stub. It burns quicker and it's a little harder to clean. Even when you get food stains on the outside, you clean it and it'll still be there. You have to go back in 2 or 3 times to clean it. So that's another con. But with all that aside, I love these pots. You can make soups, you can bake chicken, you can put it in the oven, you can put it over the fire, you can put it on your stove, you can put it in the fridge. Making meat in here, like, you could do so much with these pots. I've tried making rice in this pot, it didn't go well, it burned really quick, I guess because of the thickness of it. So I wouldn't advise you to make any rice in this, but apart from that, everything else, like, this thing is a one-man show. Like, it does everything, right? Almost everything, but it does so much, and I love these pots. They are worth the price, I believe. And I have the large cast iron pan that I use for, like, frying stuff. Love that one, so I use it for everything. So I would definitely encourage anybody that love cooking to definitely get into these cast iron pots and pans. It's worth it. Okay, you could declutter a lot of your pots that you use in your home and just have these, and it will go a long way, and you probably don't have to repurchase pots and pans if you're there. And it's safer because it doesn't have half of these chemicals that non-stick pots and pans have. So yeah, that is my take and my tea and my thoughts on the Le Creuset and the stub pot. Okay, so this week's favorite is the Fenty lotion. First, I didn't buy the hype because I thought people were just gassing it, but I must say, this lotion is bomb. I bought it during the Sephora sale. I said, no, let me try it out, because everybody's always talking about how great it is and how moisturizing it is and how it makes your skin glisten. I mean, do you see that glow? It's thick, it's soft, it's very, very silky. It goes on very easily. And, you know, it doesn't sit on the skin. It's not oily. Like, I really, really love it. And I take a nice big glob and just smear it over my skin. Like, and it has a nice subtle scent. It's not so strong, because I can't stand a strong scented lotion. It makes my nose burn. I cannot do it. But it's a nice, soft, really pretty scent. And pricing wise, it's a bit much, but you know what? It's a treat. I say try it. Going on walks is something that I want to incorporate in my life again. Me and my husband used to do this all the time prior to having a baby. It's so super relaxing. You get to clear your mind. You get to look at your neighborhood. You'll be so surprised how many things you have in your neighborhood just by going on walks. Definitely this year, as I spoke about in my last video, I wanted self-care to be like at the top of my list of things or goals of that I want to accomplish this year. And self-care could come in so many forms. It doesn't have to be doing a facial or getting nails done or going to a spa. It could be something simple as going to walk or making a nice cup of tea or pouring yourself a nice glass of wine or just sitting on your couch watching your favorite movies or cooking shows or whatever you choose or you desire or love or like. I felt it after I finished walking because I'm still going through postpartum, you know, so I was in pain after a little bit, but my body just have to get used to it. You can use that time to talk to God, to pray, you know, to really just be with your thoughts and the sound of nature and enjoying the weather. It's something that I really, really love doing. And I hope that is something that you guys can incorporate in your day to day. It's so beneficial for your body. It is beneficial for your skin because you get to get your vitamin D, fresh air. You know, it's healthy physically, mentally, and emotionally, even spiritually. So I would definitely say incorporate going on walks into your daily or your self-care this year. It would change your life.